Welcome to Arkansas Wildlife and our brand new spring 2017 season. We've got some great episodes lined up for you this spring and summer, doing the things we love to do in Arkansas's great outdoors this time of year, turkey hunting, fishing, also bringing you some behind the scenes work from the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission, and as we did last fall, some great outdoor cooking segments. We're gonna kick things off this week with a trip up to Gaston's White River Resort, doing a little trout fishing on the White River. We'll be back right after this break. Arkansas Wildlife is brought to you in part by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price, every day. Academy. When it comes to trout fishing in Arkansas, really the first place that people think about is that mountain home area. You've got the White River, which is our biggest trout water, running from Bull Shoals for about 100 miles. The North Fork River, which meets the White at the community of North Fork. But it's just a beautiful part of the state. You know, the White River cuts through the Ozarks there. And when you're fishing, it's not just about the fishing. You can see bald eagles. You can see great blue herons. And, you know, it's just a fantastic place to fish, but also the scenery there is just so incredible. We started fishing directly below Bull Shoals Dam, for it's a very large dam, 8 hydropower units there, and they had several of them running that day. So that's one of the big challenges to fishing the White River system, is how the hydropower generation, those water releases, how to play that and catch fish, whether it's low, whether there's a lot of water coming out, or whether it's somewhere in between. It's springtime, and you know, you can trout fish in Arkansas year round. It was a little bit cool when we started, and it wasn't just the air temperature, but the fishing was a little cold to start with. Didn't really start off with a lot of success. There he is.
Alrighty, buddy.
Oh! Dirty rat. But in the hands of a guy like Frank Saxa, it doesn't take long to kind of figure out what those fish are doing, and Frank's really good at finding them. Frank, how long have you been guiding up here now?
I actually started part-time in 1982. And then I've been at Gaston's now almost 24 years, 24, 25, I kind of lose track. But pretty much full-time for the last almost 18 to 20 years, full-time. I always tell people I've been guiding here so long, I've got no excuses.
I've been fishing for trout in Arkansas pretty much my entire life, and I'm pretty confident in being able to go up there by myself and catch fish. But man, having a guy just, you know, basically is a shortcut to success.
Yeah, this side here, this side was usually, this is called the upper pool. I don't know if you're...
You know, they know the river. They're on there every day. They know, you know, what kind of flies or lures are working at a particular time of year, or even a particular time of day in some cases. So, you know, being out with a guy like Frank that knows the river, knows how to read it, knows the current conditions, what's been happening, is, like I said, is really a shortcut to success. There he is. Tiny.
There you go. That's the good picture I wanted.
There we go.
Right there.
That's one of the ones they stock.
Yeah.
A little brown. On the first day, we tried a couple of techniques. We used some micro jigs, or very small marabou jigs, basically chicken feathers, 1/16, 1/32nd, even up to 1/64th of an ounce. Throw those out, let them drop, count to about 7 or 8, depending on the depth of the water, and then you pop that lure. Let it drop back down, pop it again. Usually the trout are gonna hit it on the fall. The other technique we used were stick baits, bass fishing technique, really. I mean, a jerk bait, suspending jerk baits. throw it out there. Three treble hooks on it, so lots of hooks. Really trying to target the larger brown trout with those stick baits, throwing them up a little bit closer to the bank and then jerking them down, letting them sit for a minute, sometimes for, you know, actually 10, 15 seconds, popping them again, trying to trigger strikes from some of those big brown trout that live in that part of the river. We were having a little bit of trouble dealing with moss that was washing downstream with the hydropower generation. And that was a problem throughout the spring up on the White River. But you know, especially when we were throwing the big jerk baits with three treble hooks on it, so you've got 9 hook points, kind of hard to get it through there without snagging a little bit of the vegetation. But what wasn't that big of an issue? And we kind of figured out how to play that. Frank, like I said, having a guide, you know, he knows how to sort of avoid some of the problems that might come up.
Pretty little fish.
And as the day went on, the fishing just got better and better and better. And pretty soon, we were really stroking them and putting them in the boat.
There he is.
Oh, there you go. That's what we're talking about.
Oh, he is spunky.
Right there.
Nice. God, that fish just crushed that thing.
There we go, see right there? Pretty little fish. Just lift him up. Yeah, there's still a couple to catch. There's still a couple fish out here to catch. This is a little better one. A little brown. Oh, nice brown. Stay on there, stay on there. Come on. It's a little male. See that hook jaw?
There it is.
All right, buddy.
Little rainbow.
You're throwing up on top of that ridge I was talking about earlier. That's a pretty rainbow, isn't it? Been in the river for a while. Hold still. Don't let you go. There we go. There's a little male. He's got a couple of little scars on his cheek.
Catching any fish is a thrill, but when you tie into one of these big brown trout, they just fight a little bit differently. It's hard to kind of articulate the difference.
There we go. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Brown.
Here we go. That's a nice little brown trout. He's skinny, but he's got a good length to him. He felt good. What the White River is famous for.
Oh, there he is.
You know when you've got one, just the way they surge against the line. And when you catch, you know, one of those big, beautiful brown trout and all those you know, colors of brown and gold with the red and blue spots, it's just such an incredible fish to catch here in Arkansas.
Arkansas Wildlife is brought to you in part by Arkansas's own PK Grills, maker of the new PK 360, the best and last grill you'll ever buy.
Exciting. We're at Gaston's. It's 2016 big media event that goes on. Larry Ray comes in, helps out, and Clint Gaston happens to be here.
For the past several years, Larry Ray, who's the longtime outdoor editor, now retired from the Memphis Commercial Appeal, has put together this media event at Gaston's, inviting riders from really across the Southeast, in some cases all across the country. And it's really just an opportunity for these riders to come in and have a good time, get several stories, and in the meantime, promote Arkansas and our great trout fishing resource that we have here.
You know, the outdoor media event is something that we put together in order to let the outdoor riders know about what we do here. That way they can further, you know, spread the story and let everybody else know that they come in contact with about what we offer here. So whenever the outdoor riders are here, we really cater to them, make sure that they have a real good time. And in return, typically, you know, we get articles, blogs, and, you know, some good content out of it.
When you think of trout fishing in Arkansas, one of the first names that comes to mind is Gaston's. The resort has been there a very long time. Been in the family, of course. Jim Gaston, not too long ago, passed away. Was a huge supporter and promoter of tourism and especially trout fishing in Arkansas. But that resort is just so iconic. All the little pink cabins that people associate with it, the restaurant there that sits out over the water. When you're in the restaurant, you can sit out and watch people drift by and fish, or if you're out on the river, look up at the restaurant and see people in there dining. But it's just a place that's been so important to the development of trout fishing in Arkansas, and that industry that is such a big economic driver in that north central, very rural part of the state.
The thing that makes us most unique is, for one, you know, we're a fourth generation family-owned business. We've got a private airstrip here on the resort where planes can fly in, come and go as they please. We've got a restaurant that overlooks the White River, and it's very rare you'll find a restaurant with a better view than what we have. We've got cottages all along the river. You know, I mean, you can step out the back door, throw a rock, and hit the water. And, you know, fishing's our main pastime, but we also have hiking trails, nature trails, conference lodge. You know, we do a lot of corporate retreats, family reunions, and then just, some small family get-togethers. My great-grandfather started this in 1958. Whenever he obtained the resort, it was just 20 acres, six boats, and six cottages. Whenever he passed away, my grandfather, Jim Gaston, you know, took over and really built it into what it is now. It's very rewarding, it really is. One thing that I've noticed is these families that continue to come back and visit our resort, we get to watch them grow up and kind of see the people that they become. So, you know, while I'm fourth generation, I also see a lot of fourth generation, you know, people who come back to the resort. I'm a firm believer in you start at the bottom and you work your way to the top. You know, it definitely takes a lot of hard work and it's frustrating at times, but it's all the little things that work up to the big one. I used to pick up cigarette butts, pick up trash. You know, I've did all the maintenance in the cottages, helped do some construction. Used to guide on the river for several years. So I've kind of worked every aspect of the resort. And, you know, I think that's crucial in order to run the resort the way it needs to be done. Every day I wake up and I just love coming to work. It's not even work for me. It's just something I enjoy doing. You know, you come to Gaston's for the memories. We're very accommodating. We try to go out of our way to make sure that you're going to have the best experience possible.
Arkansas Wildlife is brought to you in part by Zimmerman Sports Center on South University in Little Rock.
This was a two-day event for us, so we got to fish a couple of different ways. And on the second day, we went out with another one of Gaston's guides, Rob Shaw. And, you know, a little bit tougher conditions. Pretty cool that morning. Of course, not so much the cool weather, I think, but the thing that was really causing us a lot of problems was this moss. And, I mean, you really couldn't retrieve your lure without it getting hung up in some moss. And of course, fish aren't gonna eat a bait with a string of green slimy stuff
hanging off of it.
I gotta tell you, I've done a lot of bass fishing in my life, and you know, bass like to hang around vegetation, so sometimes, you know, depending on what lure you're using, you come back with a little salad on your bait. But I hadn't really dealt with it that much in trout fishing, and you talk about frustration. I mean, pretty much every cast that I made, the lure came back with this green, slimy goop on it.
This makes the fishing a little more difficult than usual.
The stuff is floating downstream, so you had to make your cast where your retrieve really wouldn't come back through any. You had to find certain kind of seams in the water. For whatever reason, the moss, algae, whatever this vegetation was, wasn't, you know, in those seams. But really, the only thing you could do was go out, cast out, retrieve your lure, and, you know, if you got the stuff on it, just whack it across the water and try to get it off and try again. I ask a lot of people, what's up with the moss? Talk to the guides, talk to a lot of people that fish up there a lot, and, you know, I got a lot of different answers, but I think probably the top answer, a lot of the guides and anglers up there attributed it to just high water. There was a lot of high water throughout the spring, and I think that contributed to the presence of that green slimy stuff that kept fouling our lures. We finally grew tired of fighting the moss, that vegetation that was getting on our lures. So Rob had an idea to go anchor up in a productive seam at the head of an island. And we started using natural bait. And if you fish for very long, you know, it's usually hard to go wrong when you're fishing with something that actually has a smell and a taste. The fish kind of like that.
All right. Ooh, that's a chunk.
You know, when you're anchored there, it's kind of a calm. It's more of kind of the way I think a lot of us grew up fishing, just a very simple type of fishing that really anybody can do. One of the great things about that is Scotty Wyatt, one of our producers and videographers, got to do some of the first trout fishing that he'd ever done before.
I've lived in Arkansas most of my life and mainly done only bass fishing on creeks and rivers. So I'm used to, you know, setting the hook, you know, jerking the lip off the bass, you know, and this trout fishing is a little different. It's really light, and if you set it too hard, you can just snap the line completely. And so we're casting the live bait out, you know, with a little bit of weight on it, and it's kind of just bouncing along the bottom. And you know, every little bounce, is that a bite? You know, I don't know what these trout are supposed to do. You know, are they gonna hit it hard or, you know? So, but sure enough, you know, I got a little bite, and I set the hook slight, you know, lightly, not jerking its lips off or anything. And sure enough, I had them, brought them in and caught my first trout, rainbow trout.
And this media event at Gaston's typically ends with a big shore lunch where you take some of the trout that you caught that day, clean them, set up a fire on a gravel bar and enjoy those fish right there on the river. There's really nothing quite as satisfying as eating the fish that you caught just an hour or two earlier. What a great trip it was. You know, the shore lunch capped off a great couple of days on the water, a full belly, some fantastic scenery there in the Ozarks, and some wonderful memories of fishing at one of Arkansas's premier trout fishing destinations.
Arkansas Wildlife presents the Watch and Win giveaway. During each episode of Arkansas Wildlife, we'll give away an Arkansas resident hunting and fishing license, a $35.50 value provided by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Visit the Arkansas Wildlife webpage at agfc.com/ArkansasWildlifeTV and click on the Watch and Win icon to enter. This week's winner is Damon Corbett from Sherwood. Congratulations and thanks for watching. Arkansas Wildlife TV isn't the only way to learn more about outdoor recreation and conservation in the natural state. The award-winning Arkansas Wildlife magazine can be delivered to your mailbox for just $12 a year. A subscription consists of 6 bi-monthly issues, including the popular Arkansas Wildlife Calendar. Get yours today.